My name is Terry Johnson, and I'm a student at The Ohio State University, majoring in construction systems management, and I'm also a student athlete, so I run track. Went to Liberty Elementary, and then the middle school, went to Ames, or Arts Impact Middle School, and then high school, went to the Eastmore Academy. The best accolade that I'm proud of, say being a state champion in the 4x4 my senior year. And I can also say being runner-up in the 4x4 my junior year. And the personal, individual achievements I made in high school don't really mean as much to me, just because the relay is like being able to work hard with my team and really achieve that success with my team, like meant way more than just like winning on my own, because you can always win on your own. I would say my biggest motivation, and it's kind of like a blessing and a curse, is live the life that I feel like my father missed out on. So I kind of feel like I'm living two lives, one for myself, kind of one for my father that's missed his childhood and missed his adulthood. So that's kind of like one of the big motivations that I don't really talk about much, but it's really like a big motivation for me. And also another motivation is just leading by example, because I feel like growing up, I didn't have that many older cousins. I didn't have an older brother or anything, so I didn't really have no male role models that like I could watch and see and learn from a lot. So like my biggest thing is to lead by example, so whether it's my close friends, whether it's my younger cousins or my little brother, they can see me and say they want more out of themselves just from seeing me. So my passion is to give others the opportunity and to help others get the resources to do the things that they want to do, and kind of like have the free rein to do things. Cause I feel like a lot of people in my community growing up haven't really had the resources or the opportunity to do things outside of the things they see. So like my passion is really to open up the eyes of the community, of my friends and my people I'm close with, to kind of see things that's not tangible for them right now, but really to just expand their horizons and achieve more than they could ever think. Cause I feel like that is something that everyone can do, but just if you don't have the resources or don't have the opportunity to really achieve those things, then it's harder to reach for those. First thing I do, I really try to relax the weekend, like the week before. And then after that, I just like the little things, just try to focus on each training day, make sure the training day goes well, make sure I'm eating the certain amount of foods. I may eat the same food every Monday or every Tuesday, just so my body is used to a certain feeling. And then once I get closer and I'm feeling good, I make sure I rest and then start getting like my music playlist. I make sure I have the great music that's getting me hype or getting me just relaxed as possible. And then one thing, I've done this since high school, sometimes I'll just sit and like watch on YouTube like different track montage videos or like different motivational videos. So I've watched like Kevin Durant, LeBron James, I've watched Calvin Johnson, just showing that that monster that people bring out of themselves. So like when it's time for me to compete, I'm just locked in and I'm getting in that mode. So it's really just like a mental thing, just to get my mind thinking about just competing at a high level and just going after it. The biggest adversity for me has been just seeing firsthand like my father being taken away from me, and like, and kind of like going through life not having that guidance, that father guidance, or like teaching me how to become a man. And I feel like it was tough, and it is adversity, but I've just been blessed that my mom has stepped up as much as she could to make sure I was the man that the world needed, basically, even though I didn't have the father to kind of steer me that direction. And also I can give a lot of props to like my grandfather for stepping up and teaching me how to be a man also. In December of 2020, I'll be graduating Ohio State with my bachelor's in construction systems management. And also I'm a president of a student organization on campus called Redefining the Athletic Standards, which is an organization for like supports black male athletes and really allows athletes to use their platform in a positive way. Really, to separate yourself from your community and just the situation you've been in, you gotta, one, stay true to yourself, 2, you got to be disciplined. So you got to stay on top of your things. And 3, sometimes you got to make sacrifices. You can't do everything everyone else is doing if you want different outcomes.